This video provides information on common questions and important things you need to know about subdividing your site. The new allotments should be functional and should allow for building setbacks that can be compatible with existing development in the locality. If the land division is approved, then all existing buildings will need to be demolished and removed from the site. You are responsible for arranging your own licensed demolition contractor. All demolition work and clearing of materials must occur before Council will grant final clearance to the land division. If you wish to retain the existing dwelling, then you should speak to Council's planning team to get further advice on this type of project. An easement is a section of land which gives someone the right to use the land for a specific purpose, even though they are not the owner of the land. For example, an easement may contain a council stormwater pipe for drainage purposes. Easements cannot be built over unless the easement authority approves the encroachment. Therefore, an easement may restrict what can be done over that part of the site, and this includes building works, excavation, and filling. Easements are identified on the Certificate of Title. New allotments must be able to dispose stormwater to the street. Council's preference is that allotments should be able to naturally drain to the street. However, where there is significant land slope to the rear of the site, this may not be possible, and an engineered draining system may be required. The developer is responsible for costs associated with an engineered drainage solution. If the Planning and Design Code identifies the site as being within a flood overlay, then you should contact Council's planning team for advice on the project. Excavation, filling, and retaining walls may be required to support development of sloping land. However, such works should be minimised where possible, and the height of retaining walls should be kept to a minimum to limit impact on neighbours. Excessively tall fences and retaining walls may require approval and public notification in some instances and may not be supported by Council. For further information on the land division process, please contact Council's planning team.